the town of London, large as life, the ghost of Anne Boleyn walks, they declare. Poor Anne Boleyn was once King Henry's wife, until he made the headsman bob her hair. Ah, yes, he did her wrong long years ago, and she comes up at night to tell him so, with her head tucked underneath her arm. She walks the bloody tower with her head tucked underneath her arm at the midnight hour. She comes to warn King Henry, she means giving him what for. Gadzooks, she's going to tell him off for having spilt her gore. And just in case the headsman wants to give her an encore, she has her head tucked underneath her arm. Sometimes gay King Henry gives a spread for all his pals and gals, a ghostly crew. The headsman carves the joint and cuts the bread. Then in comes Anne Boleyn to queer the do. She holds her head up with a wild war whoop, and Henry cries, don't drop it in the soup. With her head tucked underneath her arm, she walks the bloody tower. With her head tucked underneath her arm at the midnight hour. Along the draughty corridors, for miles and miles she goes. She often catches cold, poor thing. It's cold there when it blows. And it's awfully awkward for the Queen to have to blow her nose with her head tucked underneath her arm. With her head tucked underneath her arm, she walks the bloody tower with her head tucked underneath her arm at the midnight hour. One night she caught King Henry, he was in the canteen bar. Said he, are you Jane Seymour, Anne Boleyn or Catherine Parr? For how the sweet and fairy Anne, do I know who you are? With your head tucked underneath your arm.